The important thing is good tasty food. And if babies like their food, they'll eat what they need.
So you know they're getting good nourishment.
Hey, hi, what's going on, gang? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to my channel if you are new. This channel contains videos that will be able to help heal more than 90% of any health, wellness, and body image challenge. So please do subscribe to this channel. I really do appreciate it, as subscribing is where the support does come from. And today's video, we're gonna have a little discussion on the number one challenge that my clients have when it comes to changing their lifestyle in terms of what they are putting into their bodies to help heal health, body weight, body image issues, and general wellness challenges that they have. The number one blockage people have is not enjoying the taste of healthy food. I hear ya. I do. And there's a little bit more going on behind the scenes than just eat it, it's good for ya, stop your whining, quit your So I want to talk about why healthy food tastes bad and what you can actually do about it to change that.
Catch the taste.
Because a lot of people tell me that they feel as though they're doomed to not enjoy food anymore. Or they're gonna be too stressed and unhappy and depressed from not enjoying nourishing themselves anymore to properly enjoy their life. And you know what? Stress is numero uno in terms of the killer. So even if you are changing your diet to help heal other challenges you may be having in terms of health, wellness, and body image, if you're stressed out about it, if you're depressed because it just sucks to live that way, because you just don't enjoy it.
It's really bad.
You don't like it. That's gonna backfire on your health, and you're sort of negating the things that you're doing to help yourself heal. So let's blow this out of the water. Let's discuss why this is happening and what you can actually do to change it.
Sit down. We need to talk.
The reason why any health food tastes bad to any of us is because of a loss of touch with natural food instincts. It's sort of one of those unfair disadvantage situations that we actually do inherit our taste buds. However, our parents were eating and what they were eating does transfer into us when we're born. And not only that, the lifestyle that your parents have and the lifestyle that they are training you into as you're growing. So what are they feeding you? Are they giving you processed sugar? Processed foods that contain chemicals and sugar?
Dad is just catering to these boys out of the freezer with highly processed food. Fish sticks.
Dogs, little mini cheeseburgers.
These kids have got used to eating food that we know is really high in fats and sodium, and if these kids are being fed on that constantly, then how are they actually having a nutritious, balanced meal?
I don't really know how to prepare vegetables.
Most of us in Western civilization have been brought up with the SAD diet. That is the standard American diet, full of white flour, white sugar, processed food, food additives. The standard American diet is full of packaged foods that are highly processed and contain heavy doses of chemicals and sugar, and even a lot of hidden sugars as well. So those end up being the only foods that our taste buds become familiar with. What happens here is an addiction. Sugar is a class one drug. It has been shown via studies that sugar can be more addictive than heroin. The only difference going on here is that sugar is socially acceptable. So until you do come off of sugar for a period of time and take your body through a sugar detox, you often don't even realize how addicted you are to these things.
Rats on a sugar water diet exhibited telltale signs of addiction, binging, craving, and withdrawal when the sugar was taken away.
Food addiction is a real thing.
It's not a metaphor. It's a biological fact. Studies show that your brain lights up with sugar just like it does with cocaine or heroin. In fact, sugar is 8 times more addictive than cocaine. So if you start your baby early on addictive, highly sugary foods, they're going to become addicted.
Eventually, over time, certain foods in this processed sugary food category, full of refined sugar, are going to taste horrible to you. It took me a good chunk of time to change my own eating habits when I started becoming optimally healthy. I went through very similar withdrawal symptoms as drug addicts do coming off of a drug when I decided to take myself through a very serious sugar detox. It's just not practical to think that you can just go cold turkey from a regular standard American diet full of crap, being refined carbohydrates, refined sugars, artificial food additives, and processed foods. It's just not practical to come off of all of that and think you can just go balls out into an optimally healthy food diet without those consequences. You're gonna wanna say, screw this, it's not even worth it, and you'll rebound back into your old eating habits. So how do you transition your tastes? How do you retrain your taste buds to actually enjoy healthy foods? I have gone through retraining of taste buds with clients over the years, and the absolute number one thing you need to pay attention to is to make very small changes. You gotta kind of trick your taste buds into enjoying these healthy foods. And I don't mean swapping one thing out even right away. Some people take a lot longer than other people, and there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. That is okay. The point is, you need to do it in a way where you can succeed. So as an example, what I would suggest with someone that has a high intake of sugar in their coffee or tea, just the white refined sugar, rather than 2 teaspoons, you're gonna cut that down to 1.5 teaspoons for a bit. Maybe about 2 weeks. I know, it's so small, but it's not really noticed. And then cut it down to 1 teaspoon. And then cut that down to 1/2 teaspoon. And as you cut it down, you then can start replacing. So 1/2 teaspoon of white sugar, a little bit of stevia, or a little bit of maple syrup in your coffee, or a little bit of honey in your tea along with the white sugar. And you very slowly replace it so that your taste buds are actually getting used to it on their own as you're going, and there is no real adjustment period that needs to take place. If someone is drinking a high quantity of sugared sodas per day, so not the diet variety, try cutting down from 4 cans of pop per day to 3 cans of pop per day. Eventually, 2 cans of pop per day and 1 can of flavored soda water per day. And this is how we do it when it comes to things like that. 2 or 3 changes per week is the absolute maximum. And I don't even go 3 changes per week with people. Usually it's 1 change per week. If they feel ready, 2 changes per week. If they feel totally ready to go 3 changes per week, and then halfway through the week they think, I can't do this, no problem, no judgment, come on back a bit and walk a little bit slower. The more gradual that you can make changes to your body, the easier they are for the mind to accept. Eventually, you'll finally realize you can live without it. If I eat something that's processed sugarful now, oh, it's way too much, can't handle it, it's too sugary, I really don't enjoy it. I can literally taste the sugar in bread. It's amazing. And I genuinely now prefer higher healthy fats and veggies. It's unbelievable what a sweet potato or a carrot can taste like to you. It ends up being like candy. A banana, that's a treat to me.
Sweet, still packed with energy. All those vitamins and minerals, natural food sugars, just taste better. Delicious. You don't know what you're missing. Why don't you find out?
This is all about not being on a diet. You don't want to be dieting. You want to be transitioning your lifestyle. This is a lifestyle choice. It's the lifestyle aspect of these changes that create that health, wellness, and body image success in the end. It's about experimenting and finding out what works for you, and knowing that the slower you make the changes, the more willing you'll be able to accept them as an actual way of life in the long run. One of the reasons I find that people tend to give up on their goals is because their expectations aren't in alignment with reality. The reality is that healthy food is not going to taste appealing after years of being on processed foods, refined sugars, even tomato sauces, salsas, soups, things like that have white sugar in them. Anytime you flip over a can of any kind of pasta sauce or whatever, more often than not, not in every case, but more often than not, sugar will be on the label. When it says sugar on its own, that is refined sugar. There are also different names for sugar. Here's a list of them. Think about that. This is all sugar. This is what we're eating. It's hidden in the foods that we're eating. So it does take a bit of practice to check out labels as you're shopping. Read the labels and try to avoid the ones that have added sugars in them. They are still hugely flavorful. So just change your expectations first off.
Patience, patience, my love.
And understand that it will take some time for new foods to taste good. I always recommend a minimum of 6 weeks up to 12 weeks of a grace period to really decide if you like a certain food or not. You're not gonna like every single healthy food. I don't like certain healthy foods, but those are personal tastes and not entrained tastes. This is where we need to be able to tell the difference.
Mind plays tricks on you. You play tricks back!
Did you know that toddlers take up to 10 times or more of trying something that's introduced into their diet before they will begin accepting it? Why would it be any different for you, especially after way more years than a toddler of eating all of these processed sugary things? So as an example, if you were never introduced to something like spinach as a child, you're essentially going right back in time, redeveloping those tastes and unlearning the bad ones.
Great start.
As a closing thought, you cannot expect yourself to all of a sudden play an instrument perfectly, all of a sudden lift a ton of weight right away, run a marathon, whatever it may be. You're never going to be able to do those things immediately. You can't expect to be able to automatically do those things. And it's really unrealistic to expect anything different about your eating habits. I have been there. Many people that I have worked with over the years have been there. It is possible, and as well, to hack a delicious recipe, even peanut butter cups, ice cream, potato chips. It is possible to hack even comfort food meals, spaghetti and meatballs, lasagna. You can hack these things into healthier versions that aren't gonna spike your insulin and render your body unhealthier than before you were eating these things. These are guilt-free, healthy versions of these foods. Please comment below if you have any recipes you'd like me to hack or any ideas on that matter. If you want a video of that in the future, please give this video a thumbs up and I will see about creating a video like that. There are other videos on this channel of recipes that I have done. Please hit that little bell notification icon if you would like notifications of when future videos are posted. And again, please subscribe as that really does help support me. Stay tuned as well for what's coming up down the line. I'm doing videos on IBS, where that actually comes from, what the heck is the root cause of IBS, and how to help get rid of it on your own. More delicious recipes, and of course, my health hacks. So until next time, have super amounts of fun in your life. Have super amounts of fun making these changes. It can be a fun process. Trust me, it's possible.
Your future is whatever you make it, so make it a good one.
Check out my information in the description box below. I post a lot of things concerning food swaps on my Instagram as well. That is linked in the description box, and I'll see you next time. Bye.